Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. In today's game, we've got two wide receivers who love to make an impact and be number one receivers. It's DeSean Jackson going up against Dez Bryant. With that, we'll send you out to Arlington, Texas. Here's Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
Thank you, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the Lone Star State and Mammoth AT&T Stadium in Arlington, Texas. Today, we've got a good NFC matchup on tap between the Washington Redskins and the Dallas Cowboys. And hello again, everybody. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Godden here in the booth. And Chuck, you take a look at this matchup. I don't know if it's going to be one in the trenches from the quarterbacks out, whatever. It's going to be a good game.
Oh, without a doubt. I can't wait to see the big fellas have an impact. We're always spotlighting those wide receivers and quarterbacks and running backs and even the defensive backs. But the big guys, I can't wait to see which one tilts the balance for their team.
Dan Bailey now to put the ball in the air, and we are underway from AT&T Stadium. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. And now we get a look at the Redskins offense, and we get a look at Kirk Cousins. He turned 28 on August 19th, and the gift from his coach, Jay Gruden, gave him the game off.
How about that? A night off as he turns 28, but it's also a reward for all the great play from last year and really seizing this team. It is definitely his squad.
What are we going to do for you when you turn 28?
We didn't do it a long time ago.
A first down throw for Cousins. And Reed with it over the middle. And he lost the football. Here's Jones, and a short gain across the 15 to the 17-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup. It'll be second down. Starting 11 here for the offense. It's going to take some snaps here in a second. Wide receiver Pierre Garçon, always been a very good force in this league.
I agree with you totally on that. Even as a youngster, played with a fury, played with force, continues to do that now as a veteran, and knows how to mentor the younger guys.
Cousins gives to Jones on the delay, and he'll lose yardage here, back to the 15. It's a loss of two, now third down.
That play almost seemed like a baseball play. See ball, hit ball, but in this case, see guy with ball, tackle guy with ball.
Crowd getting in it a bit already. Here's an early third and 10. And on third down, the Cowboys bring in an extra defensive back. Play fake, Cousins. And that one drops incomplete as he got popped as he was throwing it.
Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
So now here's the third-year man from Oklahoma, Tress Way, on to punt it. Lucky Whitehead back deep for Dallas.
Hey,
And a fair catch called for and made just inside the 35-yard line. So possession goes over here on the punt. And leading the Cowboys out there, the veteran Tony Romo saw his first action this last week of the preseason since week 12 of last year when he had that collarbone injury.
The best part, he stayed healthy. And I know everyone is caught up in Dak Prescott and Dak mania right now, but for the Cowboys to go where they want to, which is deep into the playoffs, Tony Romo is going to have to lead them.
One man on the backfield, Elliott. And he'll get it up the middle. And he'll get this only up to about the 35. 2 yards on the carry there. It'll be second down. And here's a look at the starting offense. Second down. And this is incomplete. He was trying to get it to Ezekiel Elliott. And they're going to have a third down. And now a look at the Washington defense.
Josh Norman was not a first-round pick when he entered the NFL, but he always thought he should be. Never lacked for confidence, and now he plays at a Pro Bowl level.
And the offense looks to pick up the first here on third after that incompletion. Throwing on third down, Romo finding time. And he dropped it. Now it was tipped, altered the ball a little bit, but he dropped it. And now fourth down.
Well, we're not playing 3 yards in a cloud of dust football anymore. I kind of get why those old school coaches sometimes didn't want to throw the football. Because if it's popped up in the air, it almost turns into slow motion. And both sides trying to get to the football, and you're holding your breath wondering whether it's going to go good or bad for your team.
And a bit of a mistake there. This is well into the end zone for a touchback. A look at Washington as they come onto the field. And the first drive, three and out. Second possession, see if they can get a little momentum.
And oftentimes that first drive is just a feeling out process. You have some plays that you've got called and you want to see how defense reacts. It may not go terrific on the first one. Now they're ready to go. They've kind of got a look at them, got a sense. Let's see if they open things up a little bit.
See if they open things up. Let's see what the defense does here, too, after a good stop. They'll start out on the ground with Jones. He juked him, and he's brought down. That one goes for 13 yards, and it moves the sticks. And there, Matt Jones, the ball carrier. Last year, only 3.4 yards per carry. Did have some explosive plays, though, in the passing game.
And they think that they're going to get him in the running game from him now as well, because the volume of carries for him will increase.
Jones, and he is going to lose yardage here. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And the offense there, the O-line, everybody really on offense, they were just manhandled at the point of attack.
Yeah, you could pretty much call them all out, couldn't you? And almost by name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a lost yardage possibility?
So not much to speak of scoring-wise in this first quarter of play. Nothing, nothing, our score. We're back to Arlington in just a moment.
This presentation of the NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade. The Sports Fuel Company.
Back live, Charles Davis to my right. I'm Brandon Gauden. It's Redskin football to begin quarter number two, but they face a second and long to start things out.
Why they haven't scored any points so far. I think it's time to abandon the run game, spread things out, and go to the air. It certainly can't be any worse than what they've done so far.
Yeah, they've got an extra defensive back out there now on third and 13. Third and long for Cousins. He finds his target. It's Crowder. And he's brought down after a good gain. And a nice gain of 21 yards.
He went full scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. Looks like this will likely be the last play before we hit the two-minute warning.
Let's see if they can sneak one more good play in before the two-minute signal.
2 minutes remain in a scoreless first half. We're back to Arlington right after this timeout. A reminder, coming up at halftime, we'll check in with Larry Ridley for highlights and analysis of our first half of play. Not too many highlights yet, at least in terms of scoring plays, that is.
Yeah, but hang in there. We might get something these last 2 minutes.
And the offense lining up first and 10. First down, here's Cousins. He's got time in the pocket. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Now a second down throw for Cousins. His throw incomplete. Pierre Garçon, the intended receiver. And it'll be third down.
You know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
And they'll need the 39 here for a first. This is third down. And defensively, it's a nickel formation here on third down and nine. On third down, Cousins. And this time he's got the hookup. It's complete. He got 18 yards out of that one, and it gets him a new set of downs. And now the passing game here in the second quarter starting to heat up a little bit.
Don't you feel the rhythm starting to happen, right? You see it now. The confidence is starting to rise. I think now as a play caller, because that has happened, you lean on it a little bit more. You don't go totally away from running the football, but you do say, guess what? We can throw it. We can throw it well with a whole lot of confidence.
Let's go. 3-19.
Cousins on first down. And this will be incomplete. He was looking for Matt Jones that time. And that'll make it second and 10.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help your defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit, but incomplete. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10.
Here we go now. Green
second down throw for Cousins. Docks him with a grab over the middle. And he's able to get it down to the 25-yard line. 5 yards on the pickup, and that'll make it third down. And the TCU product, Josh Dotson, so explosive, but had that Achilles injury. Don't know he's really been able to show the full arsenal, has he?
Not at all, and it's not as much of a concern about the speed as it is about his leaping ability. That's his stock in trade, able to go up over the top of defenders and make catches.
To the air again, it's Cousins. Completes it right side to Dotson. And he's able to pick up the first down before he's tackled right at the 10. It's a really nice 15-yard pickup, and now it's first and goal. And welcome back, the offensive unit. They took the timeout, and now they get set to line up as we resume action. And the offense readies for play number 10 of this series. First and 10, Cousins surveying the field. And there's a flag on the field.
Holding offense. Still first down.
Long drive. The defense just cannot seem to catch a break and get off the field. Again, it's Cousins. Now the hit comes, and Cousins lost the football. But the Redskins look to get this one back, and indeed they did. It's still Washington football. Now whistles come in. We're going to get a timeout here by the offense. So that means they're down to one remaining here as we head toward halftime. So the offense takes the timeout, and they are back out and ready to rock. So they almost turn it over there. Scary moment, second down here. They'll run it now out of the gun. And they won't fare much better here as he maybe gets back to the line. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're not doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature to make sure you don't get hurt.
Well, just play after play after play on this long drive for the offense. An extra defensive back on the field here for third and goal. Third and long for Cousins. He's got time. Under pressure, and down he goes. They sack him back at the 36. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. And with halftime on the horizon, they'll be out of timeouts from here forward. So the offensive unit called the TO, and now we are ready to resume play. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. This from 54 yards away. And Hopkins' kick is good. So we've reached halftime. All we have to show for the first half, a lone field goal. 3-0 our score. As we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to the EA Halftime Report, let's take a look back at the first half.
Both the Cowboys and the Redskins are having some issues finding a way into the end zone. They'll both look to improve their play on offense and pick up some touchdowns in the second half. So let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. Third and long, coverage breaks down here, and the pass and catch will end up going for 21 yards. Continuing on the drive, defense will win the battle and get the sack. This will go for a loss of 7. So that'll do it for us here in Orlando. For the call of the second half, let's hand it back over to Brandon and Charles. Brandon.